Good morning, good morning, good morning, everybody. This is Jeremiah's JMan Monero, JMan Speaks, coming to you live and direct from our world headquarters here in The Rock, the ROC, and we don't stop. Today on Ask the Experts Anything Meaningful Fridays, we have a very special guest. Michelle Lilly's coming to us from Houston, Texas. She has a master's in blockchain, folks, okay? So we're going to bring her right up now, and then we're going to hit her with the... There you go. Oh. Welcome, Michelle. You know you were. Good morning to you.
Great day, J-Man.
Yes. I'm doing great. I'm so happy to have you on here. It's an honor and a pleasure. We haven't known each other that long, but I feel like we've known each other forever.
Yeah.
So why not?
Go ahead.
Go ahead, girl.
I was going to say, but J-Man, you didn't give me my right introduction.
Hold on. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together. No, go ahead. You can.
So let me give you the right introduction.
Yeah.
I am success magnet, money magnet, billionaire in the making, millionaire, maker, global leader, phenomenal woman, extraordinaire. Michelle Lilly is in the building.
Let's go. Yeah, there we go. We hit this. Wait. Then we got this. And then for you.
I'm a savage, yeah.
That's it. Just a little sound bite. And then one of these here.
All my life, been grinding all my life.
Hey.
You didn't know you were in for all that today. Welcome. We appreciate your presence. Why don't you introduce yourself for the folks that don't know you, kind of talk a little bit about your background and how you're one of the only people ever so far to have a master's in blockchain.
Absolutely. So, definitely thanks for having me. I do feel like we've been knowing each other forever, just total synergy. Excited to share with the people today about blockchain and tokenization, but brief background about me, 2017, I was introduced to Bitcoin at $1,200 and had no clue what it was. A friend of mine and business associate, I trusted his opinion, and he told me that it was $1,200, and by the end of the year, they expected it to double. And I said, wow, well, that sounds like I could take that chance.
Yeah.
And I did, and Bitcoin started going up like $1,000 the next month and so forth. So bought more, and by the end of the year it was $20,000, and then it dropped back down. And I was like, what is this? What is this?
You're like, I'm rich. Oh, right. I'm rich.
Oh. Womp, womp, womp. You know, and yeah. So I decided that I knew it was something there, but I didn't know what. But, you know, so I started to get educated, and I said, you know, let me get educated about this. Because, I hadn't been educated about the old money, but I knew I wanted to learn about the new money. I knew that I needed to learn about the new money.
Yeah, the new money.
And so I did, and I first went and became blockchain certified, and then flew to Greece and became Ethereum certified. I started my master's program. And in January of this year, I finished my master's program, became the first Black woman in the world to hold a master's degree in blockchain and digital currency.
Congrats.
And have been educating about cryptocurrency and cryptocurrency investing. I was able to build a 7-figure portfolio from crypto, and have educated a lot of people about cryptocurrency, and then was called to ask about educating real estate professionals, specifically in the domain of about blockchain and cryptocurrency, but specifically in the domain of real estate. And so that led me to having the opportunity to meet you. And so here we are today.
And you just kind of breezed over the fact that the first female Black woman in, not in the state, not in the U.S., not in North America, but in the world.
In the world, Craig.
Okay. I see you. Okay. So let's, what do you want to, start with blockchain first and then go over to the tokens, or where do you want, you tell me.
You tell me what do the people want to know?
I think maybe let's start just a, you know, macro overview of blockchain, how that works. Cause I think it's one of those things where you got to hear it. I had to hear it at least 10 times before it finally was like, click. I get it now. So mm-hmm. blockchain as it applies to real estate. Well, maybe start there.
Okay. So, well, first, before we, I guess we can get to blockchain before it applies to real estate, let's talk about what blockchain is and then how can it apply to real estate from that standpoint. So blockchain is more so just a distributed database or ledger. And is shared among a node of computer networks. And so the way that I like to explain it so it makes sense to the everyday lay person is think about Uber. Now, you and I understand that Uber is not decentralized. Mm-hmm. And blockchain is a decentralized network, right? But for purposes of this conversation, so people can understand, let's pretend that Uber is decentralized. I think it's one of the closest examples that we can use, right? And so when you think about Uber is shared, the Uber network is ran by the cars, by the drivers. Just like with blockchain, the network is ran by computer networks, meaning that you and I can run a node. So pretend that node, the driver is the node.
Right.
And when a transaction happens on the blockchain, it's broadcasted to one of the nodes, right? It's broadcasted to the entire network. And one of the nodes, just like an Uber driver, accepts that transaction, if you want to say, right?
Okay. Yep.
And so they basically, they say, you know what? I'm going to accept that transaction. I'm going to go, and because I accepted that transaction, when I go pick that person up and I drop them off, I get paid for that. So I get a reward. Just like if a miner does on the blockchain, when they accept that transaction and they validate that transaction on the blockchain, they get a reward.
And that's crypto, just, right?
Pardon me? In crypto.
Yeah. Yeah. So that's mm-hmm. where like Bitcoin came from initially.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. And so everyone in the Uber network, when the transaction is first broadcasted, everyone can basically can see that, hey, someone needs to be picked up at this time. And the transaction is recorded that where this person was dropped off at and so forth. And so it's similar to the blockchain that the same thing happens with it. So it's distributed, it's trust. You don't have to trust anyone. Because it's a public ledger. So the same thing with the Uber network, everyone can see where that person got picked up, where that person got dropped off at. And so it's transparent. And it's immutable. The biggest thing that it's immutable, meaning that you cannot go back and say that transaction didn't happen. And that's where the public ledger and the distributed ledger happens. So think about if we were voting on the blockchain, because everyone can see everything that happens, no one can say, you know what, that vote didn't happen or that vote was fraudulent.
Right.
And so let's take that to real estate. And so think about a deed being put on the blockchain. No one can go tamper with that. It's immutable. You can't go tamper with that deed. And if anyone tampers with it, everyone can see who put, because a new block would have to happen. So right. Everyone would be able to see what happened, what person put that block on there and the information that they put on there that changed that deed. And so
hold on, I just want to, let's just to kind of slow it down for them. Mm-hmm. Think of like, if I have a house and I'm going to mm-hmm. sell it to you, Michelle.
Correct.
Right. When that happens, a new block is created.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, when you go to sell that house, that's another block. And then the chain is the linking of the blocks. That's where blockchain.
Correct.
Right, really make it really basic for them. And then every time, like you said, there's a new block, there's a bunch of nodes and nodes. I like to think of nerds, best way that like I think of it, in a good way, right? Networks of people that are verifying. So it'd be like every time a house sold, you had hundreds of people going, let's verify that Jeremiah's actually sold this to Michelle. Oh, all of us, we all agree. Yep, everybody agrees that that's where that immutable comes in, right? It's not like an attorney recording something and then that's in a back room somewhere. If eventually it gets recorded in the county clerk's office where then there's room for fraud and there's room for error and there's room for all that.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So it keeps us honest. The blockchain keeps everyone honest. And you don't have to rely on a central point of authority.
Now, like I heard someone at one point talking about, like, could you on that same history have like all of the repairs you made to the property, like everything related to the property could be on there. So now it's like you don't need my receipts that I might have printed yesterday that I got the kitchen done last week and my friend came and did it.
Exactly.
Like the history of it. It's on the blockchain. It can't be disputed. Here's all of my, like, this could change. It will change real estate.
It will change. Yeah. It will change real estate. And there's also where you can have the transfer of deed on the blockchain. And so it'll change real estate in that title companies may not be needed.
Right. So there may be some pushback from them.
Yeah,
because there won't be as much title insurance money that they're getting. It's not necessary.
It's not necessary because everything is transparent and immutable on the blockchain. So it will definitely impact. And what I'd like to say about blockchain technology is because a lot of people, when I'm educating, they, especially when I teach about cryptocurrency investing, oftentimes they think that they are just investing in the coin or the token. They don't realize that they're actually investing in blockchain technology. Because what most people don't realize is that without blockchain technology, nothing. There is no cryptocurrency.
Right. There's no crypto. There's nothing else. Everything rides on it, right?
Everything rides on it. And so when you are investing into a token or a coin, and you think about cryptocurrency, you're investing into a project or a company essentially that's building a product on blockchain technology. And so no different than Amazon wouldn't exist without the internet. Microsoft wouldn't exist without the internet. So these coins and tokens, and so I'd like to distinguish that because people think crypto is different than that cryptocurrency is this thing on its own, not realizing it's the blockchain technology that is really what's most important when it comes to cryptocurrency investing as well. We are investing in blockchain technology and each one of those tokens or coins, unless they don't have a utility behind them, you know, your meme coins and so forth. If they don't have a utility behind them, then you're just investing in a meme coin. But other than that, you're investing in some type of coin or token that is building a utility utilizing blockchain technology.
Okay. You got that, folks? Any questions? And when you watch this on the playback too, just, you know, you can put it in the comments. We'll reply. We'll get you Michelle's information at the end of this and some exciting certification programs that she has in the pipeline that she'll be doing nationwide in a city near you. Okay. So you mentioned tokens. This is kind of a good segue. So tokens are, you hear about them, but most people don't even know what the hell you're talking about, right? You say, you know, got tokenization, real estate and the tokens and the coins and the crypto. And then next, you know,
token is just a digital representation of a real world contract, real world asset. Especially when we talk about tokenization in real estate, tokenization is just the digitized form of that real world asset. And so tokens allow us to do something unique in the real estate, in the realm of real estate, which is allow us to fractionalize real estate and provide liquidity to a industry that typically is illiquid.
Okay, let's use some smaller words. fractionalize, meaning like take a property and cut it up into pieces, right? And liquidity, guys, is like one of the challenges with real estate is if I invest in a property and I want to liquidate, like I had a client of mine who had, you know, 30 something rental properties and there was a moratorium on evictions. And now he's like, I want to liquidate all my assets. You can't do that overnight.
No.
But with this, you can, right? Mm-hmm. Being liquid means like, hey, this afternoon, I want to go, I don't want all these tokens.
Correct. So breaking that down more. So typically, so let's think about a REIT.
Yeah, Real Estate Investment Trust. Yeah.
Right. So typically you have a group of people that invest into a REIT and they purchase different properties and they receive dividends for their pro rata share into that REIT. So when you think about fractionalization and breaking that down, basically is so say you and I had $1 million condo, a group of us were buying $1 million condo and we said, you know what? You said I'm gonna put $100,000 in. I'm gonna put $100,000 in. So we got 10 people to put $100,000 in. And so that is 10%. We all received 10%. And that was distributed to us in tokens versus, and those tokens, remember, are just digital. That digital contract is then programmed into that token. And so now, but because of the blockchain, yeah, it allows us to sell our tokens to someone else. And when we sell our tokens to someone else, it transfers, when those tokens are transferred to their wallet, that means that the interest in that property is also transferred to that wallet. And we don't have to trust. Remember, trustless, that's one characteristic of the blockchain.
We don't have to
trust that, you know what, that we really did that, because the blockchain keeps a distributed ledger of everything that happens. So we know that those tokens were transferred to your wallet, and it allows us now, and it doesn't affect anyone else that is holding interest in that property, because the LLC owns the property. The token holders own interest in the LLC.
Okay. Now, how is it different from a real estate investment trust then? Because I think that's the question where a lot of people ask, like, oh, I've heard of REITs. It's like a REIT. What's the difference between the two?
The difference is that we don't have to sell the property for you to sell your tokens. So say, for instance, something comes up, you have an emergency come up, or you just want to take the money that you've invested, that $100,000, and invest in another property a year from now. And so now you're able to sell your tokens. And if the property has appreciated, because the tokens are backed by the real world asset. And so if the property has appreciated, you're able to sell your tokens at that appreciated price to someone else automatically, same day. You don't have to go close at a title company or anything. And all of your interest rights transfer directly to that person. And so you can get liquid immediately.
So let's use your example just for round numbers. $1 million condo, 10 of us go in at 10% each, 100 grand, that appreciates 50% over the next couple of years, is now worth 1.5 million. So now my 10% is worth 150,000.
Uh-huh.
Right? If I want to sell that token, I then sell it at the 150 because it's the market value of the property. Like there's an appraisal process. It can't be overvalued.
You can't
sell more tokens than the property is worth. Like it's worth $1 million. You can't sell 2 million worth of tokens, like crowdfunding, you know, where you just get more and more and more and more. You can't, because it's backed by a real life asset, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
And so if I make that money, I keep that as if it was a dividend, as if I like cashed out a stock or something, right?
Yeah. Just like that. just like that. So you keep that, just like you cashed out a stock, the person that is purchasing it from, purchasing those tokens from you can purchase them in cryptocurrency from you. They can purchase it in real life cash. They can wire you the money. However, and you transfer those tokens to them, they get all the benefits that you enjoyed and the same legal rights that you enjoy from the transfer of those tokens.
And because it can happen so quickly, you don't have to worry about the volatility of crypto. Like if in a typical real estate transaction might take 30, 60 days, I'm not writing an offer in Bitcoin today because 60 days from now, that may not be worth anything or may be worth more. It's less speculation there.
Glad you asked about that. So, tokens that are utilized for real estate typically do not have the volatility of the market, simply because the token is actually backed by the asset and it's not being exchanged on a cryptocurrency exchange like Coinbase or something. The token is just being exchanged on either a secondary marketplace, which allows for someone who wants to invest into that property and you can sell out of it. So whether Bitcoin goes up or down, it doesn't affect the value of your token. But if your property goes up or down, that's what affects the value of the token. It's pegged to the value of the property.
Okay. So are there platforms that are doing this right now? I would imagine that there's approval required, SEC, right? And you're talking, it is dividends that are paid. It's not like other things real estate related.
Right. There's a couple that are doing it. And one of them, they are not SEC regulated. They're saying they don't have to be, that's up to the SEC. But Realty, they only accept accredited investors, the one that you have up right now. So you have to be an accredited investor to invest on Realty's platform. And then you have Lofty, .ai.
So what does accredited investor mean for those who may not know?
So an accredited investor is, and don't quote me on this, but it's someone with who is accredited, who I think is $250,000 or more a year, who earns or has a net worth of $1 million or more.
Okay, so not the average everyday person. Let's just say that.
No, not the average everyday person. Absolutely.
Okay, because not all of us are making $250K a year.
That's right.
The average American. Okay, so that's you have to be accredited to use this.
Next.
Right.
Yeah. So on Lofty, what's interesting about them is that you can invest for as little as $50. So that's the beautiful thing about tokenization as well, is because now you can take smaller buyers with larger buyers and take down properties like $1 million condos in Miami that maybe someone wouldn't normally be able to participate in, still receive the same cash on cash returns that the bigger investor receives, but it's just based on the amount that you invested. This is where the game changes significantly.
So anything else we need to know about that? Like, I'm investing for $50. I imagine $50 gives me like one small, like 0.0001% of a decent property. Is that how it works? And then are they, like you said, prorating the return on that? And then I get pennies on the dollar? I mean, what am I getting for $50, really?
So, you know, they allow people to start investing for $50. And of course, you know, so you have some smaller people some smaller investors that may only invest $50. But think about this. Think about someone working at, say, Walmart, for instance, and or someone who has a lower income and they're only earning, say, $400 to $500 a week. And so now they can start building real estate portfolio with as little as $50, yeah, with Lofty, yeah, to start, you know, hey, I have a little bit here, but next week I did a little more. And so typically, because they didn't have that as an option, they didn't invest in real estate at all.
Right. Right.
And so it left those people kind of shut out of the market, if you want to say, from the real estate investing side. So what fractional ownership does, what tokenization does, it opens up to a diversified audience that typically weren't able to participate. And so that is where the real game changes, because now you can allow the masses in to participate in something that was typically left to your accredited investors, your institutional investors, your cash buyers, or those with really good credit that allowed them to leverage their credit and invest in real estate. This now opens it up to your everyday college student.
Okay. So I, you know, as I have a little bit of money, boop, just let me buy me a quick little, these are still called tokens with Lofty as well, right? Or what are they?
Yes, they're still called tokens.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Then we just buy a token every now and then when I have a little bit of extra money. And then, you know, 10 years from now, I got a little bit of
right.
something, which which should appreciate over time, because real estate appreciates over time as well.
Correct. And better than just sitting in the bank and earning.
Right. Not even keeping up with inflation.
Like, exactly. Or yeah. just spending it because you don't feel like you really have a vehicle to invest in.
Now, here's a good question. If I wanted to do something like this, then, you know, like typically with like your 401ks or your pre-tax dollars that go into something, when I want to, I buy in and I want to cash out, there's no tax. I mean, there's tax implications if I'm, and we're not an accountant, nor will we play one on a live stream, but there are tax implications just on if you made money, just like anything else, you'd get a 1099 or something like that. Is that?
That's exactly how it works. Mm-hmm. Okay. You receive a 1099.
And you know what's funny? It makes me laugh when people go, oh my gosh, I got to pay all these taxes. And like, it's better than the alternative. If you made no money, you would pay no taxes. So
absolutely.
So that brings us to the tokenized marketplace. What's
yes.
going on here? What's going on here? Tell me.
So I'm excited. I'm excited to share. So, you know, when I was educating about real estate professionals in Miami, and I was educating about tokenization, I was talking about tokenization during the workshop. And I was like, wait a minute, you're educating about this? You know blockchain, you know real estate. I'm a real estate investor as well. I was like, so why wouldn't you just build your own platform? And that's what we did. And so we are launching this platform in November. Very excited to be launching a platform. So it's a tokenized platform as well, allowing for tokenization of not just middle, I would say, but luxury properties as well. And we're tokenized assets. So real estate is the main focus of the platform, but we are tokenizing things like oil wells.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, you're in Houston. That makes sense.
That makes sense. Absolutely. Yeah. But I just want to show the diversification of what tokenization can do, where tokenization, not just real estate, but any asset. And so on our platform, you get to participate for as little as $500. And you get to participate in opportunities that typically we wouldn't be available to the average person. Or even think about, let's talk about a seasoned investor. Seasoned investors who may even have cash, but nowadays what a house costs $500,000, that's like the low price nowadays for a house.
Yeah.
And I'm being, you know, of course funny here, but
no, I mean the bigger cities, I mean it's like $1 million listing used to be an impressive show. Now that's like, okay, in the bigger cities that's
right.
almost everything.
Exactly. So now people get to participate for as little as $500 in assets that they normally would never be able to even invest in. But when, as I was sharing about your seasoned investor, you may have a seasoned investor that is liquid and they may have $500,000, $1 million cash, but instead of them having to go purchase one property and now they're in one property that they're illiquid in, now they can spread those funds across several different properties that still is giving them the cash on cash return, that still is giving them a good IRR at the end of the day. And now they get to say, you know what, when I want my liquidity out, I can pull my liquidity out.
Yeah, that makes sense. They're diversifying. It's still stable, still tied to real estate, but they don't have to sell either, you know, you have a whole bunch of properties, a portfolio of properties, or one big property, which may not move as quickly depending on the scenario. So we got a question from Billy P. in Billings, Montana. Billy P. Billy, you got to change your profile photo from the Chicago Bears to the Buffalo Bills to get your questions answered.
No, Chicago Bears is fine, Billy. I'm from Chicago.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Well, look it. You always have 1985, the Bears, Ditka. That was a great team. But she has a question. What is the biggest risk of investing in tokens? Good question.
Let me see. What would be the biggest risk in investing in tokens? If the property goes down in value, the value of your tokens go down. That is definitely a risk that could definitely happen. If the market drops and the values of the properties drop, I would say that would be the biggest risk. The other biggest risk. If you lose if you can't get into your wallet or something that your tokens are held in, that would be the other biggest risk. Because of the blockchain, a lot of risks are taken off, but you still have the same risk associated with, let me say, traditional real estate investing.
Right.
So if for whatever reason, we focus on our platform, we're focusing on passive income. So we're focusing on rental properties that produce either daily rental or monthly rental. So they're income producing. So say for instance, if a tenant is not paying, you still have the same, that means you're not receiving that income that you're receiving just as though it was offline. It's not just because you have tokens that it automatically that the money automatically comes in. So you still have those same risks associated with tokenization that you would do as if you just own the rental property offline. The difference is with tokenization is that there's a third party property management company, and so you don't have to manage the properties.
Yeah, I was just about to say that. I think one of the biggest challenges for people coming in as an investor getting started, it's like, I want to buy a rental property. Okay, well, how are you going to manage it? How are you going to make repairs, right? If it's outside your market, you're investing in Rochester and you're all the way in Florida or New York City, like, how are you going to do that? And that's where a lot of the mistakes are made in the beginning. You hire the wrong person. They don't manage it correctly. Repairs aren't made. And that causes your tenant not to pay. Like, that's a whole domino effect. But I like what you said in regards to like real estate, guys, is it really not going to be appreciating
right.
in the long term? And this isn't like don't think of this as a day trading scenario either.
Yeah.
Right.
It's more
like
not day trading
long term. Let's let it sit there. If real estate takes a little bit of a hit, which it may, depending on the market in the next 3 to 6 months, it's still going up. It's still going up. And you guys, are investing in areas that are appreciating rapidly in big cities with high demand, right? I mean, I think you mentioned Miami a couple times, and I think Miami is head and shoulders above the rest of South Florida in general, head and shoulders above the rest of the country as far as condo tells, crypto, block, everything. I think they're the mecca of all that.
And they are.
See it expand from there. Well, I know you got to get on another call. Is there anything kind of like in closing we should tell them? You have a certification program. You're going to have that on demand pretty soon, right? So that they won't have to travel someplace to do it.
Yeah. When I come back, I'm going to be recording and putting the certification on demand, but I'm going to be doing some lives and hopefully we'll do some of those together, JMan.
Let's go.
We'll do lives together on blockchain and cryptocurrency in the domain of real estate. And we do offer a real estate certification, which they get a certification, and their certification is an NFT that is put on the blockchain. Yes, so we're definitely excited about that. I'll get you some dates that we're putting those dates together where we'll have some lives, but they will be on demand as well. And as I just share with any of the realtors or real estate professionals out there, you know, Blockbuster didn't pay attention.
Right? Yeah.
Right? Yep. The taxi cab company didn't pay attention. They tried to fight with Uber.
Yep, that's right.
Pay if
the hotel industry didn't pay attention.
The hotel industry didn't pay attention. Note to self, pay attention. Because here's the truth of the matter, just to leave them with this. The wealth has shifted from the baby boomers to the millennials and to Gen Z. Those are your new buyers. Mm-hmm. That is our new audience. They are very comfortable with cryptocurrency. Not just tokenization, but even purchasing with cryptocurrency. And you want to be able to speak the language of this new buyer. And you can't just write it off or dismiss it as though, you know what are they doing over there? They're always coming up with something and so forth. Yeah, Blockbuster found out real quick when Netflix basically put them out of business.
That's
and
right.
Redbox.
That's right.
So you definitely want to be able to speak to that buyer. You definitely want to be able to speak to that audience. And so getting educated about blockchain and cryptocurrency in the domain of real estate will help you have those conversations. You don't have to be a true expert about it, but if I'm a buyer and I want to use cryptocurrency, 10% of, I think 11% of new buyers in 2021 noted that their down payment came from cryptocurrency investments.
Okay.
That's a big deal.
Yeah, I mean, and I'll just add to it, just like Michelle said, we're seeing the largest transfer of wealth in our nation's history. Period, from the boomers to the millennials. So those of you who are in big cities who looked past us millennials and you were like, you guys don't make no money. You can't afford to buy in my city. Guess what? Pay attention, speak their language. And if you have investors that are liquid and have money to invest, real estate folks, don't worry. There's an opportunity for ambassadors and affiliates with this program. Hit me up for more information. Michelle's got to go. Where are you going? Where are you going today? Hold up. Let's just drop it on him.
I'm dropping. I leave for Dubai.
What?
And I know. Then I leave Dubai and I go to Rome on the 14th. And then I fly from Rome to the Maldives. So I'm excited about I'll be
okay. I thought I was Mr. Worldwide, but I'm meeting Miss Worldwide over here, getting it done, going where I love it. So thank you so much again for being on with us. Greatly appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
Let me come back over here. And guys and gals that are watching, look it, we're going to put Michelle's information in the comments. This is the future, okay? We're bringing you the future in the present, like always. And if you don't pay attention, you know what happened to the dinosaurs that didn't pay attention? Rah! Just walk yourself over to the tar pit, and we don't have to see you no more, okay? Retire from the business because the future is now. My name is Jeremiah. J-Man Monero, J-Man Speaks. Thank you so much. Let me see. I want to hit him with a little something before we go. A little music. What do we got here? What do we got? Oh, I'm going to hit him with this. Here we go.
Lunes, yo me llamo Tazán y la gente me dice, ¿cómo es?
El rey de la selva.
Jane es perfecto gracias a sus raíces.